Well, what we're seeing here is that, and combining this with previous studies that have shown that people at the 20% bottom of the distribution, their income grows at the same rate as the income per capita for an economy. So this is slightly different from what happens at the top of the distribution. So we might start thinking that if the income growth is unevenly distributed in different segments of population, then we might do something about it. And that might imply tax policies, progressive, even more progressive policies that we currently have, and using those resources to help people at the bottom part of the distribution and in order to have a more egalitarian society. But again, that's my point of view, and that's my perspective, and that's probably not necessarily shared for other people. And that's some people are more concerned with the efficiency effects of these redistributive policies. But I think in the end, if we what we care about is about having a more homogeneous society, having a more egalitarian society, probably the discussion should move into that direction, and how to do that better without generating large distortions, so that not to impede those at the upper part of the distribution to invest enough, because probably, as has always been said, these people at the upper part of the distribution is also the ones who invest, are also the ones who create jobs, are also the ones who generate opportunities. So we don't really want to tax them as much as in order to generate distortions and reduce incentives for them.